Good morning students, welcome to our next lecture of artificial intelligence. We are discussing the first unit, that is the introduction to artificial intelligence. In our today's lecture we will study the topic solving problems by searching. That means how we can solve different types of problems in artificial intelligence by the method searching. So there are many approaches for searching a particular goal state from all the states. In searching we are having many approaches for searching the goal state. That means we are given the initial state. In some types of searching we are also given the goal state, but not in all. So when we are given the goal state we can easily find the path, but when we are not given the goal state then it will become difficult and time consuming for us and our system to find the goal state and the path of reaching the goal state. So the first technique of searching is BFS and second one is DFS. In today's lecture we will study the both breadth first search and depth first search. Since we are familiar with both the terms as we studied BFS and DFS in data structures which comes in our third semester subject, that is data structures and algorithms. So let's again study BFS and DFS with respect to the artificial intelligence. In BFS, that means breadth first search, it is the algorithm for traversing or searching tree or graph data structures. We are using BFS and DFS searching techniques for traversing or searching tree or graph data structures. That means we can apply BFS and DFS searching technique on tree or graph data structures only. BFS starts at the tree root. BFS starts at the tree root and explores all of the neighbor nodes at the present depth prior to moving on to the nodes at the next depth level. What BFS does? BFS starts traversing or exploring from the tree root. That means in BFS searching technique we will start traversing the tree or graph from the root node, and after that, starting from the root node, we will explore all of the neighbor nodes or the children or subchildren nodes of the root nodes till the depth level, or we can say that till the goal node. So for understanding BFS we are having an example. So this is our example. We are having an example. We are given a graph. In this graph we are having nodes S, A, B, C, G and D. S is connected to A, A is connected to B, B is connected to G and C, and C is connected to G. Similarly, S is also connected to D and D is connected to G. So according to this graph, suppose that S is our starting node or root node, and G is our goal node or destination node. G is our goal node or destination node. So according to BFS we will start traversing from the node S, as node S is our starting node or the root node. Now as we studied just now that BFS technique starts at the tree root, that means BFS technique starts from the root node and explores all the neighboring nodes of the root node till the depth level. So for solving this example using BFS technique, we are having S as the starting node or the root node, and G we are taking as the goal node or the destination node. So we will start traversing from the starting node or the root node S, and we want to traverse to the goal node, that is node G, and For traversing or reaching the goal node, we will search a path. We will search a path to move from root node to the goal node. So, we will search the path from starting node or the root node to the goal node according to the BFS technique, and the path should be the shortest path as possible. So, what we will do for solving this graph, we will construct a equivalent search tree for the above graph. So, for this graph, we constructed a equivalent search tree of this above graph. So, according to this graph, since S is our root node and G is our goal node, so according to this graph, we are constructing an equivalent search tree. So, we have taken here S as the root node, because S is our starting node and the root node. So, S is the root node. Now, we will see S is connected to how many nodes. S is connected to A. So, for left subtree of S will become A, and S is also connected to D. So, right subtree will be D. After that, we will see A is connected to B. So, A is connected to B. Further, B is connected to C and B is connected to G. So, B is connected to C and B is connected to G. And further moving, C is directly connected to G. Now, and after that, D is connected to G also. So, we have constructed an equivalent search tree of this above given graph, so that we can easily implement the BFS searching technique on this tree. Now we will search the minimum possible path from root node to the goal node. So, root node is S and goal node is G. So, we will find the minimum shortest path possible from the root node S to the goal node G. So, after constructing this equivalent search tree, we are starting traversing from root node S. So, we will start from this root node S. Now, for reaching the goal node, we are having two paths, from S to A and from S to D. Suppose that if we take the path from S to A, we will traverse after S, come to A. Then after traversing A, we will come to B. And after reaching B, we are again having two paths, directly to node G or to node C and then to G. So, on the left subtree, we are having two paths, and by considering the right subtree, we are having the path S to D and D to G. Since we want the minimum or the shortest path from the root node to the goal node, so the path which BFS technique will search will be S to D and D to G, because using this path we are reaching the goal node in the shortest path, which we cannot get from the other subtree. So the path using BFS technique from starting node S to goal node G will be S to D and then D to G. So, this will be the path which we will get after implementing the BFS searching technique. Now, coming towards the DFS technique, in DFS, the algorithm starts at the root node. DFS technique starts from the root node and explores all the nodes as far as possible along each branch before backtracking. DFS technique uses backtracking because it starts at the root node. After starting at the root node, it directly goes to the depth of the tree and then backtracks to explore all the remaining nodes till the root node of the tree. So, for solving this example, using the DFS technique, we are having nodes S, A, B, C, D and G. S is our root node and G is our again goal node. So we have to traverse from node S, that is the root node, to the goal node G. So for traversing the path from root node S to goal node G, we will apply the DFS technique. DFS technique traverses the deepest node first. So always keep this thing in mind, and this is the major difference between BFS and DFS technique. DFS technique traverses the deepest node first. That means DFS technique will always traverse, will always take the path with the deepest node, and it would always pick the deepest branch until it reaches solution. So the main difference between BFS and DFS technique is BFS technique always uses the shortest path, and DFS technique always uses the deepest or the longest path for reaching the solution. So for solving this graph using DFS technique, we again constructed an equivalent search tree that we constructed in BFS. We constructed an equivalent search tree. S is our starting node, S is connected to A, and S is also connected to D. So on left side we have taken A, and on right side of S we have taken D. Then A is connected to B, B is further connected to C and G. So C is on left and G is on right. Then C is connected to G, and moving the right side or the right subtree of root node S, D is connected to G. So this is the equivalent search tree which we constructed from this given graph. Now what we will do, we will apply the DFS search technique, the DFS technique, to explore the path from the source node or the root node to the destination node G. Since DFS technique traverses the deepest node first, and it will always pick the deepest branch, that means we will consider the longest path to reach from the source node to the destination node. So we will start traversing from the root node. Then we will move firstly towards A. After moving towards A, we will move towards B, node B. After moving towards node B, we are having two choices, either to move to node C or directly move to node G. Since DFS technique chooses the deepest node, so we will not consider this path, that means B to G. We will consider the path B to C and C to G. So the deepest path from source node to the goal node will be S to A, then A to B, B to C and C to G. That means S to A, A to B, B to C and C to G. So in this way we can reach the goal node by using the DFS technique or the deepest node technique until we reach the solution. So this was all about BFS and DFS technique. That means in BFS technique we always take the shortest path, well, otherwise, and in DFS technique we use the longest path or the deepest path. So this was all about the solving problems by searching, that means BFS and DFS techniques. I hope you all have understood. Thank you very much.